In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create a paper airplane by using Bridge Edge Loops, Loop Tools Loft, and Grid Fill. I'll also show you how to clean the grid-filled mesh, and shape up the mesh by aligning, moving, scaling, and rotating the vertices. Let's create a single vert. If you don't see that in the menu, please activate an add-on called Extra Objects. On the front viewport, I'll type E to extrude the single vert like this. Let's hold Ctrl to snap to the grid. G and X to move on the X axis after that. It's easier to rotate a grouped vertices later if we extrude while holding the Ctrl key. Here is our basic shape. Let's use Shift, D, shortcut to duplicate, and type, Y, to move them on the, Y, axis. We can scale the meshes like this. Let's Shift select all the meshes, and Ctrl, J, to join them. We can mirror the joined meshes afterward. I'll apply the modifier, and duplicate it on the X axis twice like this. I'll show you how to create a paper plane with the bridge edge loops, the loop tools loft and the grid fill. Let's go to edit mode. 2, to edge select. Press Ctrl, East, to bridge edge loops. That's how easy it is to bridge loop a mesh. Let's move on to the second mesh. We'll use the loop tools add-on. In edit mode, right-click to go to Loop Tools Loft. If you don't see that in the menu, please activate the Loop Tools add-on. The third method would be the grid fill, but we'll need to work on the mesh a bit more, in order to make it work. In edit mode, if we press Ctrl, F, and select grid fill, the grid fill won't work. To make it work, we must manually select and connect the end vertices by using the F key like this. After that, type 2 to go to edge selection mode. Shift select the edges like this. Ctrl F and select the grid fill. Do you see something on the grid fill mesh that doesn't exist on the other two? I don't know if this is a bug or not, but previously mirrored meshes seem to create extra edges after grid filling them. We must fix this issue manually, by merging the vertices by distance. But there's a possible bug related to that as well. In edit mode, type 1 to select the vertices, A to select all, and try to merge the vertices. None of them were removed. If we change the distance to 0.1, some will be removed. Only 5 vertices were removed for some reason. There are far more extra vertices that are creating an odd visual issues on the mesh, so we must clean them by all means. We could manually select and merge 2 vertices each by using the M shortcut. But there will still be hidden vertices that are stuck. The ones we can't see apart, because they're located way too close to one another. We can adjust the merge distance values manually to see if that would help. Please look at the bottom where it shows how many vertices were removed. This is one of the reasons why I do my best to avoid using the grid fill in Blender. I was making the futuristic shoe tutorial's upper part segment like this, and gave up multiple times after spending too much time. The best thing to do would be selecting the close vertices manually and merge them with the M shortcut. It's very important to zoom in order to spot the vertices that were not merged. Let's align, move, rotate, and scale the vertices to shape up the mesh. I'll compress time, because this process will take too much time. I'm selecting the vertices that are not straight, and use S, Z, and 0 shortcuts to align them on the Z axis. Please use the proportional editing to edit the position of multiple vertices at the same time. The time compression ends here. Control 3 to subdivide. Right click and shade smooth to smooth the surface. Control R to add loop cuts to make the edges sharper. I'll add light RGB colors to the meshes. Let's add a ground plane. For the ground, I'll use a dark metallic material. Let's turn off, use nodes, under compositing. I'll also use 32 samples to render. This is the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching.